Hello everyone. In this video, we'll talk about structural optimization in Ansys Mechanical. In Ansys Mechanical, there are four different types of structural optimization under a topology optimization system: the density based, the level set based, morphing, and lattice optimization. In this video, we will cover the density based and level set based topology optimization, and also the morphing node-based optimization method. The lattice optimization method enables to create lightweight parts using lattice structure with optimized graded density, and has already previously covered in a previous video. So the next three slides will present each of the three optimization methods along with some pros and cons, and then I will show you a quick example for a model solved using each of these three structural optimization methods. So let's start with the density-based method. So this method is also known as the solid isotropic material with penalization, or SIMP method. So this method has been widely used and is available in most topology optimization software. So the general idea behind this method is to find an optimal distribution in a predefined design space for a predefined amount of material. Basically, all the elements in the mesh will be attributed a density value, the so-called design variable. This density value will either be 1 or 0, where 1 means an active element and 0 means an inactive element. Additionally, to provide something better than this 1 or 0 solution, a global penalty parameter using a power law function is added to this method. This allowed to weight the density of each element. In other words, we are transforming this discrete optimization problem, the 1 or 0 solution, into a continuous optimization problem where the pseudo element density will vary between 1 and 0. So one of the weaknesses of this method is that it suffers from a lack of properly defined boundary. So that's why we also have the level set based method. So the level set method may not be as mature as the density based method, but will provide an unambiguous solution that does not rely on data interpretation like the density based method. So this method directly deals with the boundary of the shapes during the optimization process. So it pushes the boundary instead of playing with element density. So when we compare this this topology optimization method to the density-based method, the level set have several benefits. So it will produce a smoother contour and avoid this ambiguous and irregular design like the density-based. It will facilitate the interpretation of the optimized shape, and it will result in a watertight, smooth surface. The level set based method is also the topology optimization method that is used in Discovery Live. And this method was introduced in Ansys Mechanical with the release 2019 R2. There is also a third method that I want to talk about. So the parameter-free morphing method has been made available with release 2020 R2. So with this method, morphing optimization optimizes the shape of the model by moving the nodes. So here there is no topological changes during the optimization. So that's why this method is not really classified as a topology optimization method like the density or level set base. It is rather classified as a node-based optimization method. This method serves a different purpose than the topology optimization. In terms of strengths and weaknesses when compared to the topology optimization method like the density and the level set base, so there is no shape approximation, and therefore the calculation of certain quantities such as stress will be more accurate. However, no topology change is allowed, and this requires moderate shape modification. So now let's open Mechanical so I can show you a model where I use these three different optimization methods to generate an optimized shape. So in terms of the geometry, it really consists of a really simple 3D solid body with really simple features. There is an upstream static structural analysis that was done using like arbitrary and boundary condition and loading. So a fixed support applied here, a load applied here in X, Y, and Z, and a frictionless support here on the top. For the mesh, a tetrahedron element were used because the parameter free morphing methods only support this type of element for now with the release 2020 R2. And also two recommendations about the mesh. So we should always use a uniform mesh, so with a homogeneous element size, because this will enable you to capture the design with the same precision everywhere on the model. And you should also make sure that your mesh is fine enough. For the topology optimization, the default setting was used. So here I have three topology optimization system, one for the density base, one for the level set base, and one for the parameter free morphing. But in each system, the settings are the same except for the method that is being used. In terms of the optimization region, the design region was set to the whole 3D body. The exclusion region was set to the boundary conditions, so the three faces here in red. And so we simply modified the optimization type three times. So first we used the density base here, at the second we used the level set base, and for the third one we used the parameter free morphing. Under the objective, so we simply minimize compliance based on the upstream static structural analysis. And under the response constraint, the mass or volume constraint was set to 50% to retain. So here is a quick overview of the optimized shape for each system. So as you can see, the optimized shape is really different in each cases, but roughly the mass constraint was respected. So now let's have a deeper look at each geometry. So for the density based method, as you can see, this is a sharp non-smoothed geometry. This is really typical from a density based method like this, and this is really the result of a lack of a properly defined boundary. However, it only took 19 iterations to solve, and this was actually the fastest model to converge. Now, if we compare this geometry to the one that we have obtained from the level set base, as you can see, we got twice the number of iteration were required to solve this one. But as mentioned previously, the optimized shape produced by this method won't require too much interpretation during the geometry reconstruction. So because a simple smoothing operation might be enough. So this is for the level set base. And the last one, the parameter-free morphing. If we animate the result, we can clearly see how this method works and how it really different from the two others. So this one is really classified as a node-based shape optimization. We can really see that the mesh nodes are moving and not the element being removed like the two other method. And as discussed, such an optimized geometry, the local quantities such as stress will be much better captured during the optimization process. And finally, note that you should always use the true scale set to 1, because by changing this value, the optimized shape will change every time. So it's better to not, it's recommended just to use the true scale of 2:1 to get the final geometry. So going back to the presentation, the last step of this workflow is the validation of the optimized part to evaluate its stiffness. So to do so, each model will be, so to do so, for each model, we will generate a 3D solid body from the STL geometry. So from this geometry to this one. And this will be done in Space Claim. And if you go again in the Simu portal, so we already covered these a way to quickly reconstruct a 3D solid geometry. So if you open the Simu train, you should have a look at the tips and tricks video. It's gonna be under pre-post tips and tricks. And then if you, I think it was, use the all year filter and search for topology. And here you have a two-part video here. And part two is going to be what you want to have a look on how to get a very smooth and clean 3D solid geometry from the STL part. So once the geometry is generated, we can use it in mechanical and apply the same boundary condition of the first static structural simulation. So as you can see here, the total deformation is kind of similar, but for this particular case, the morphing method led to the less compliant part. So note that this conclusion can change and is very case dependent. However, my suggestion would be to try first the level set base and the parameter free morphing before trying the density base method. Because like previously mentioned, as you can see, these two approaches led to a better defined geometry when compared to the density-based method, especially if we look at the STL file here. And on the other hand, the level set base and the parameter-free morphing methods are newer in Ansys. Therefore, they might not be compatible with all type of manufacturing constraint or element type. For example, like I mentioned, the parameter-free morphing with release 2020 R2 is only available with a tetrahedron mesh. So you should have a look at the help documentation for the limitations of both method. So finally, even if the density based method would be my last choice, it is still a good method because it has been there for over than 30 years. And this method is very robust and is compatible with almost all type of constraint that are available with Ansys. So that's it for today. I hope this was useful for you, and have a good day and stay safe.